Hi everybody and a happy new year 2022. I hope it's going to be a good one. It's time for my 2021 bullet journal flip through, and it's probably the most imperfect one. I had so many trackers I didn't use or forgot to fill in. As a perfectionist, I hate empty space in my bullet journals, but it's something I have to accept. If you watched my 2022 setup video, you know that I am starting this year with less spreads, because I forget about them anyway. For January, I did this blackjack slash casino theme, and I'll be honest, it was such a struggle to come up with a cover page I liked. That's the pressure of a brand new journal, I guess. If you'd like to know the supplies I used for a specific theme, you can find a list in the description box of each Plan With Me video. Next up was my Vikings theme, and I loved this one. The doodles were so much fun and surprisingly easy. Maybe I should mention that I know that Vikings didn't have horned helmets, but I thought it would look cuter, and I hope you don't mind. For March, I went for this art studio theme, another one I really liked, especially the tracker spread. I'm sorry for all those sticky notes. I know they look ugly and there's probably nothing top secret underneath them. I just don't like the thought that people I don't know can just read my entire life and what's going on in my head. When I was planning my April setup, I've been going through a very bad bullet journal creative block, so I took a lot of inspiration from different setups by Amanda Rach Lee and used the supplies of Notebook Therapy's Sakura collection. I think it's probably kinda pretty, but every time I look at it, I remember the bad time I had coming up with this setup. For May, I did a theme inspired by the video game It Takes Two, because Money and I had a great time playing it. I also think the theme is kinda cute, but I stopped liking it very early because it was just too much in my opinion. I didn't really like the color palette anymore, which happens very often to me when I create super colorful setups, and somehow I stopped filling out my memories pages, unfortunately. my June theme was the first one I really, really liked again after my creative block. I only used highlighters and a brown gel pen for everything and loved the look. The gel pen ran out of ink very fast though. I used the last few pages for a collaboration with Ohuhu and created one illustration for each pack of their dual art markers. It was such an honor for me. That was the first half of 2021. Let's go on with my second journal. I think this one is my favorite yearly setup I did so far, even though it didn't get a lot of views on YouTube compared to my other ones. The waves design is inspired by Piper's art. For July, I went for something tropical and simple with only one accent color, and I think a lot of you won't understand, but this is one of my absolute favorite 2021 themes. It's also the month I started my Patreon. And even though I'm panicking every single month if I get my rewards done in time or not, I don't regret this decision at all. Shout out to everyone who joined my Patreon at some point, no matter if you're still there. You're the best and I highly appreciate your support. For August, I did this very summery coconut theme I also really liked. As you can see, I still didn't give up on my memories pages. I always thought, next month I'll do it again, but spoiler alert, I didn't. I think for 2022 I'll do more minimal versions of these pages and fill them with bullet points of my highlights instead of a full page of doodles and lettering. I'm already a little bit sad about that change, but I realized that I rather want to draw in my sketchbook for myself than forcing myself to doodle memories in my journals. For September, I did that dreamy, cloudy sunset and cityscape theme, which is really pretty, but it has quickly become boring to create new spreads for this theme. But I learned how much time it saves to use my own printables for my spreads. Thank you. October is another one of my absolute favorites because it was so fun and I love these Dutch door systems I used. Not gonna lie, the doodles took forever because there were so many. My November theme was a collaboration with Notebook Therapy I enjoyed a lot. I used their whole Maple Dream stationery collection and finally did a fox theme, and I love it so much. It's not my usual style, but it was so refreshing to try something new, and I also loved my printables that month. And for December I did a very cozy winter theme with this vellum window inspired by Abby from Will Buju for Treats. It's also one of my favorites this year. And that's it. Let me know your favorite theme in the comments, I'm super curious. I hope 2021 treated you well. For me it was a roller coaster, but I also learned a lot. Thank you for your support in 2021 and I hope we'll have a great time in 2022 as well. Thank you for watching till the end, consider subscribing if you enjoyed it and have a wonderful rest of the day.